What's going on, everybody? My name is Austin, and welcome back to the channel. So when I woke up this morning, I did not expect to be making this video whatsoever. I woke up, I rolled over, I went on Twitter, and then I found this tweet. Taking accountability from John Swan. You guys remember a couple days ago when I made that John Swan versus Dream video? A video that has since been deleted because of what I'm about to tell you. My buddy Wheatonly also DM'd me and told me that my John Swan versus Dream video didn't age very well. So naturally, I was a bit confused this morning when I woke up, because I really don't see it as a good thing when people start DMing me and start telling me that something didn't age well right in my videos. So to explain all this, how about we go read John Swan's wonderful tweet. Taking accountability. Hello everyone, as a commentator, my credibility is important to me. Unfortunately, I have let you all down. There is no excuse for what I did, and I take full responsibility. I wish I could have made a video, but I'm currently traveling and I'm not in the position to do so. I was messing around on Discord about a year back with a friend of mine. I had 6k subs and I thought nothing of it. This somehow got back to Dream and I didn't expect it to. I panicked, I told a lie, and I thought I would never get brought up again. I was wrong. Dream's Reddit post came out and I was completely in shock. I panicked again and made my thread, digging myself into a deeper hole. I thought it would look really bad if people thought I was impersonating a YouTuber, even though it was so small, inconsequential at the time, but I understand now that lying about something on as big as of a scale as this is indefensible. Time after time, I messed up. I should have just said it was all me all along, but I didn't. I dug myself deeper and deeper and got caught up with everything. I lied about a massive creator, and I'm sorry. There is no excuse. There is no need to defend me. I was brutally wrong, and I am sorry for lying to you all. I'm especially sorry to Dream for everything I did. Lying at the expense of someone else's credibility is one of the worst things a creator can do. Once again, there is no excuse. I understand if this makes you lose respect for me. In fact, I would be shocked if it didn't. I messed up on such a large scale that I didn't know if I'm capable of anyone's forgiveness, but I will try my best to earn my respect back. I have let you all down. I am ashamed and disappointed in myself, and I am sorry. I will be taking time off social media to process everything. I will return at some point, but I don't know when. In the meantime, stay safe and healthy. So John Swan's entire story about the 12-year-old kid who took his account and started messaging people on Discord was an entire lie. John Swan lied about the entire thing just so he could keep his credibility intact, which caused us, an entire community, to go out and defend him against another community that basically wanted his head, but it was all for a lie. I have never in my 6 months and my even longer, around 2 or 3 years of being a viewer and a commentary channel, been more disappointed in anyone. This whole situation and drama for me was even worse than Pyrocynical, because John Swan is a person that I have looked up to for a while now as a commentary channel and as a viewer of his content. Because after all this, I think I have lost all faith, trust, and respect for John Swan. As a commentary channel and as a content creator, I will still respect him and will always respect him for that. But as a person, I do not respect him. As you all can probably hear right about now, I am furious, because I went out of my way as a fellow commentary channel, and when I looked at those facts, I said to myself, I think John Swan is in the right. So I went out of my way to defend John Swan over a fucking lie. I am currently really angrily eating these Cheez-Its right about now, so I can put my anger into something useful. However, what I do still respect from John Swan is that he actually told the truth. And I have a quote that is very powerful and relates to this very much, but it's from an unlikely source. It's actually from the show A Football Life. So here's the quote.
He could have lied. He could have not said anything. Nobody would have known anymore.
So I do still respect John Swan in the sense that he actually came out and he said the truth. And you know, the truth will hurt sometimes, and I think everyone needs to realize that. And the truth did come at the expense of the commentary community. I'm sure it was very frustrating for Dream to have to go and read this tweet about everything and know that, well, he did lie and he said the truth, but he just wouldn't own up to it. I'm sure most of you already know, but I am not the biggest fan of Dream whatsoever. Though I may not like his content or how he acts sometimes, I will apologize for the things I did say in my last video about this whole drama. I am not a person who likes to have to apologize to people who I really don't like or the content they do, but I will say that I am sorry, Dream, for the things that I said in my last video, and that I may not like your content, but I do respect you as a fellow content creator, and I will always respect you as a fellow content creator, no matter what, along with John Swan. So again, I would like to apologize for the things that I said in my video, and for everyone watching any person's video about anything about this drama, realize something that when you do things like this on the internet and you have people defend you over a lie, you should have just told the truth. Because you may just not tell the truth later and just keep the lie going, or you can be like John Swan and tell the truth and make it even harder for everyone. In the end, on both ways, you still lose people's respect on both ends. The people who look up to you may not respect you anymore. The people who followed you and the people who are your friends may no longer respect you anymore. So when you get caught like this, or you're in a situation where something happened a while ago and you just own up to and say, yeah, I did that, it was my mistake, and I'm sorry. So people will see you as a respectful person who tells the truth instead of a person who tries to get what they want by lying. Now, John Swan earlier did deactivate his Twitter, and I don't think he'll be coming back for a long time. I still openly respect John Swan as a fellow content creator, like I said earlier, but as a person, John, I am sorry, but I will not respect you that much. So I hope moving forward, we can all realize that, you know, telling the truth is better than lying, and that especially when you're on the internet and you have a big platform, always tell the truth when it comes to things like this over something very petty and small and insignificant as this. I will not let this whole John Swan Dream thing bring me down as a fellow commentary channel. I will continue to make commentary videos because they are what I enjoy and what my audiences enjoy, and if my audience enjoys it, then I am as happy as can be. And I will not stop until I get to my goal of having over 1,000 subs. So I hope as a community and as commentary channels, we can all grow from this and think to ourselves, you know, maybe the people we look to aren't that great, but you know what? They won't stop me from getting to where I need to go. So I think I'm going to end the video now, guys. I hope you all enjoyed, and I want to hear your guys' thoughts and opinions on this whole drama and whatever in the comments. I understand that it was a pretty boring one, and it was pretty uneventful until this morning. So I would like to thank you all for watching. Make sure you guys go follow me on my Twitter in the description below, and you can join an early as fuck Discord in the description below. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.